Tapi walaupun defensif tetap bisa kena juga. Ini kalau dia naif, kita hanya cukup melakukan string seperti ini, import OS, nggak perlu pakai apa tadi yang fancy way tadi untuk restore view if, nggak perlu, karena dia sangat naif, hanya eval data aja. Kalau dia udah tambahkan build di sini, ini udah nggak bisa lagi cara kayak tadi, harus pakai ini. Dengan cara seperti ini, kena dia. Oke. Jadi cara kayak tadi ini adalah cara blacklist. Jadi mungkin dia akan memblacklist sistem, dia akan memblacklist OS, dia akan memblacklist apapun. Ini akan kecapean mendaftar apa aja yang nggak boleh, apa aja yang berbahaya. Cara blacklist akan selalu ada bocornya. Ah lupa ini harusnya ditambahkan di blacklistnya. Oh iya ini harusnya ditambahkan di blacklist. Oh iya kan kebobolan berkali-kali. Setiap kebobolan ditambahkan. Dia udah kalah berkali-kali. Kalau ini harusnya jangan pakai eval sekalian. Kalau mau tuker-tukeran data bisa pakai format-format yang ada kan, di JSON, YAML, seperti itu. Sesuatu yang benar-benar pure data ya, bukan executable. Pickle tadi data tapi dia executable juga. Eval apalagi, ini emang yang kita kirim adalah code. Lebih ngeri lagi. Oke, sampai di sini yang materi saya. Silakan kalau ada pertanyaan. Kita akan sangat capek parsing evalnya, karena bayangkan kita menerima suatu program, kemudian kita harus membuang mana di situ statement yang berbahaya. Iya. Misalkan kita terima input adalah source code, source code-nya akan dieksekusi. Bagaimana kita tahu source code itu aman apa enggak? Itu seperti antivirus, terima program, dia harus ngecek program ini aman apa enggak. Kalau aman, dieksekusi. Kalau nggak aman, masukkan sandbox, nggak boleh jalan. Seperti antivirus, dan itu nggak bisa sempurna, selalu bisa diakali. Jadi seperti halting problem. Kita nggak pernah tahu program ini run forever atau suatu saat berhenti. Itu halting problem. Banyak ini. Eval sama pickle ini paling umum. Iya. Enggak, dulu pernah ada yang cari di GitHub semua yang mengandung eval, mengandung pickle dicari. Dia secara massal nyeken semua source code yang open ya. Ada di source code, ada di GitHub.
I think besides security issues, you probably wouldn't want to use eval anyway because it's not optimized. You're not able to optimize the code at that point. Yeah. But these are obviously good points. As people make their services available, you know, I could definitely see people coding incorrectly with a REST-based API or something and not parsing those arguments properly.
Sometimes we think that this function is nobody use this function. But in practice, I find.
Do you see people using eval?
Yes.
That's scary.
Sometimes people want to be simple, right? They want to use simple.
Wow.
I don't really care about hacker. Right? Nobody care about my data. Things like that. Mungkin karena tadi ya paradigma berpikirnya bahwa usernya adalah orang kita sendiri, ngapain tuh dijaga secure banget, ya nggak perlu lah.
Pickle is quite useful if it's contained internally to your app, right? But if you're accepting that input from somebody who's untrusted, that's where the problem comes from. And eval, I could see where it could be used in certain really edge cases where you really can't optimize the condition, but it seems like even in Python, there's usually libraries that will help you to kind of avoid that situation, that you can basically deal with it cleaner, right?
Yes.
I mean, it would be like, I wouldn't just give you the keys to my car and let you drive wherever you want to go, right? It's kind of like you're handing over the complete processing power of your server to somebody when you give them eval access, because they could run whatever they want. They could run some serious GIS query and be tying up all your resources, yeah. I think the bigger danger is what you mentioned earlier about SQL, you know, SQL escaping, and that you have a lot of inputs that probably you use OWASP there, I saw. You could run OWASP against a lot of modern websites in Indonesia and probably find issues with they're not checking the inputs.
Yes.
That, to me, is probably the number one thing that you run into, right?
SQL injection is low-hanging fruit.
Yeah, exactly.
It's easy, yeah.
There was even a, as long as we're on the subject of security, I just designed a very simple Ruby site a long time ago as a company website, and the only thing I did that was any kind of programming, I mean, it was very simple, it was very static, and the only piece I had was you input for your contact details if you want to submit to our newsletter.
Mm-hmm.
So you input all that detail, and then the problem is if you're not checking that input, I would present back and say, your input was wrong, or here was what your input was. But if you're not parsing that, now you got cross-site scripting issues, which I only came up with when I ran OWASP against it.
Yes.
I was like, oh, yeah, I didn't even think about that.
Yes.
So that's always a good tool to run against your website to double-check things. Yeah.
It's quite scary, cross-site scripting, especially for the persistent one.
Yeah.
So it's like guestbook. You input guestbook, but you put script JavaScript.
Mm-hmm.
This case, it's stored on the database that everyone
who hits that will get that.
Yes.
Yeah.
One case is in MySpace and in Friendster, I think. They make warm by exploiting XSS.
Mm-hmm.
So in their profile, they put script, and everyone who see their profile will be infected.
Right.
Yeah, it's got viral very quickly.
Yeah, and like you said earlier, it could be an upload of an image or something that's not being checked. You know, that's stuff that, these are problems that everybody's known about, but the problem is, as the field of programming grows and more people get involved and they're not aware of these issues, then they go and repeat the same mistakes.
PDF bisa dicek dari isi filenya, kalau yang dari benar dari isi filenya.
Ada header dalam file itu ya, bisa. And then there's a command in Unix you can run
magic,
file
magic number,
or yeah.
Usually in exe file you can see MZ in the first byte. Something, every file has unique byte that we can identify. Ah, this is PDF or this is. So.
Tapi bisa tulis script juga yang mulai dengan MZ.
Yes. Good point. Hacker mindset usually like that. If we know the source code, we can see how this program check my input.
Mm-hmm.
He only check whether I put MZ in front. So I just put MZ and then blah blah executable behind it. Gonna be starts with MZ, it's okay. As long as starts with MZ, I accept it. That's disaster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I think
aku udah ada ya, kalau mau nanya-nanya.
Oke.
Kita kasih tepuk tangan dulu buat Marco. Pembicara utama kedua minta di akhir sesi, jadi jam 12 baru bisa datang. Kemudian sambil ngisi waktu, kita ada beberapa pembicara kilat. Terserah Mas
Isma dulu.
Isman duluan.
Oke.